Did you get a chance to intern anywhere while you were in college?
I did. I interned very late, unfortunately. I think I interned in my third year or fourth year vacations. I interned with a photography studio called Studio 127. And the moment I did that, suddenly I had this sort of learning spurt altogether, because you're out in the real world and you're designing actual things that are going to be used by clients. So there are these realistic expectations and realistic limitations also in times, in terms of idea, in terms of being able to execute something. And all of that was great. Most importantly, I learned to use the software, which was something that was not really taught in college. And whatever knowledge I had was very basic, or friends helped out again. So over there on that internship, just that hands-on experience was invaluable. And I immediately realized I wish I had done this like from year one and done it more often.
Yeah.
Because I would have benefited a lot more.
So what did you actually do in a photography studio as a designer?
It was not a very long internship. I remember assisting for a couple of shoots, but again, there I don't think I was very helpful in the photography aspect of it, because I'm really not trained. I would essentially follow instructions and hold like a reflector or something, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
But what I did work on was the books that they used to do photography for a lot of jewelry designers.
Okay.
And then they'd create the books that would go out, that would be printed, or some advertisements as well. So the design for that was where I got to work a lot, which was incredible. It was my first time using CorelDRAW.
Okay.
And that was in itself learning by fire of some sort, because I mean, a lot of people might not know of CorelDRAW, might not have used CorelDRAW,
yeah.
But it crashes a lot. And I remember learning right from the beginning that I had to save every like 5 minutes, just save that file, because you didn't know what would happen and if it would crash. So just very realistic things was stuff that I learned over there.
Real world experience. Yeah, I think save regularly is one of the best things anyone can learn.
Absolutely. I coulda, woulda, shoulda, but I definitely wish I had done more internships.
But this must have confirmed that you were on the right track and this is really what you wanted to do.
Yeah, this was something I definitely enjoyed doing. I remember working really late in the night, which was also something I enjoyed back then. All of that was, I was happy doing all the work that I was assigned. So that was great affirmation.
And after you finished at JJ, you finished your internships. This is now the time for you to start your first job. And you got your first job in Goa, right?
Yes. I got recruited at our final exhibition at JJ. A couple of people who had studied at JJ itself had come back to sort of see the final year work. And from there, it was this company called Synapse Communications. And it seemed amazing. They'd given us a small pitch at our exhibition time. They sort of selected a couple of us from the final year. And then we had a follow-up interview, followed by a round of interviews in Goa, where we were called to Goa. I think there was a test of sorts, I don't remember anymore. And then, I got offered my first job over there. I moved to Goa from Bombay. I remember my dad making inquiries with people who he sort of kind of knew in the industry to like figure out what is this company in Goa and why does it have to be in Goa and why is she moving to Goa and is this a good move and all of that. But
my favorite part of that is, why does it have to be in Goa?
That was definitely something. Because there's this idea of what Goa is like. And also, for me, my experience with Goa so far had been summer vacations with family, because my mom's family is from Goa. So
almost
every summer we'd go down to Goa. But again, it was just summer vacations over there. So it was sort of a shift of mind for me as well, that I'm going to go to Goa and I'm going to be working now. Which was really interesting. It allowed me to experience Goa in other ways as well.
How did you experience it differently?
Because you're working, you don't really have the touristy life. You don't really hit the beaches every day. You're working in an office, sometimes from morning to very late in the night. My first job, at Synapse, for the first year when I moved there, I was working under the founder and some other people who were with him, who would essentially go out and pitch to clients, pitch for more jobs for Synapse. And my job my role as a designer was to sort of execute these pitch presentations. And when I would tell all my friends who were working in agencies back in Bombay, and they were just like, why are you doing this? What is this? And to an extent back then, I didn't understand what I was learning in the process of creating those presentations. But now when I look back, I realize there was some amount of, there was a lot of strategy that would have been involved. There would have been a lot of thinking, and I got to see the thought process of people far, far senior to me, and how they sort of approached a problem, how they pitched for a solution that not only would benefit the client, but also use the expertise that the company had. And I would have to visualize this for presentation, of course. And that was incredibly valuable information for me to apply in the future. I would not know this then. But as a freelancer, you need to apply all of these learnings as well. You need to be able to understand what the client wants, and then sort of figure out a solution that works for them. And then also be able to realize that we'll be able to execute it, or who all, or what kind of skills and manpower are required to execute it. And this ability to sell yourself is something that I started learning right from the first job that I had, which is... I marvel at the luck of it all.
And it's that is an invaluable skill, being able to talk about your own skills and to sell your services, like you said.
And to sort of frame that in a way that is useful for someone else. Because, I mean, I could talk myself up and be like, oh, I'm amazing and I'm this and I'm that. But how is my skill going to be valuable for someone else? That's what you need to be able to convey the most. So that was something that I got to learn right at the beginning. Eventually, I moved on to other roles and started designing for other clients. But that first job was sort of in-house designer for those pitch presentations, which was super lucky for me.
And you would have had to work on pretty crazy deadlines, so your way of style of working would have to change.
Because suddenly they'd get a meeting and they'd be like, oh, we need this by yesterday, which is something that is fairly common in graphic design in general. It was strange. That first year was pretty intense, because there were times when I'd be working super hard. I remember I ran a half marathon that first year. I finished the marathon and then I came back to work the rest of the day. And this was a Sunday. So we worked really hard, but then also there were times when there were no meetings. And that place was pretty awesome, because they were like, we don't have any meetings coming up. What is the point of you coming and sitting and working? Please take the day off. Or sometimes it was like a couple of days off, because there was no meeting in the future. And that was incredible too, because they realized that there's no point in just calling someone and making them sit and work just for the sake of the fact that we're paying them a salary, you know. And that kind of that felt less exploitative. Because a lot of times people are like, no, we're paying you salary, you have to come in every day. And they'll make you work really hard, but also not let you have any time off. So that was amazing. Like I worked really hard that first year, but they also ensured that we had time off.